Oh, yeah, there's definitely been a few, even with Cormac. Led a lot, and he got me on the last lap last round, so, nah, yeah, it was good.
Well done, well done. Here at Jesse Stroud, great result here. Number 2NZ, number 1 in the moto. Over to you, Brad.
Oh, exciting times coming up here. This is our New Zealand Grand Prix for Formula 1 and Formula 2 sidecars. Who's it going to be? We've got the points up for grabs to our championships are both live in both classes. And it's a wonderful start for the number 12, Boss Engineering Aprilia of Anna Munsworth and Bryce Rose. They lead into turn number 4 in this shortened 8-lap sidecar feature race. So pretty exciting times here. Barry Smith and Stu Dorr, they get a good start. They are there in second place. We've also got Chris and Richie Lawrence. They are there fighting it out in third place in the Formula 1 category. We've got it all unfolding nicely. We've got Bert there back on track. Hopefully everything okay for Michael and Isaac there. The coolest haircut in the paddock, I reckon, in fourth place at the moment. We've got Brian Stent, Dan Franz, and they lead the Formula 2 category. They are there ahead of Mark Halls and Jeff Davies. As I say that, Mark and Jeff are going to pull up alongside there, I think side by side into turn number 9, and then look to Pete and Michael Dowman. They are there in third in the F2, and Tracy and Joe are in four. So the four F2s are inseparable in the track heading down to turn number 11, and we've got our top four in F1s out to fly as well. So two separate classes all out there, two separate New Zealand Grand Prix up for grabs, and there we go. Can it be the perfect weekend for Adam Unsworth and Bryce Rose? The pole position, the bonus point they got there, they've come and won 2 out of 2 so far, but this one is what really is going to count. The New Zealand Grand Prix for Formula 1 sidecars up for grabs, as it's not much in it out of the flip-flop. We've got Chris and Richie Lawrence talking to Jan just before, and this was 30 years ago today that Chris and Richie Lawrence won their first New Zealand sidecar title back in 1993. So we'll look out for them, and they're still in their 3NZ in the New Zealand Grand Prix at the moment. As then we look to Richard there ahead of Michael and Isaac. So still fourth for those guys on the Penrite Kiwi Bike Insurance Machine, and then go into that F2 battle. That is going to be brilliant, as Mark Halls, Jeff Davies lead ahead of Brian Stent, Dan Franz, and then go back to the girls. They have now got into third place in the Formula 2 class. They have got a 5-point deficit in the championship. If they can win this race, they'll tie it on points, but maybe what is required in this Formula 2 class is Brian and Dan. Can they get ahead of Mark and Jeff? We've got so much to look out for, so much to talk about, and 7 laps to go in our New Zealand Grand Prix for our sidecars. Adam Unsworth and Bryce Rose started this championship after round number 1 with an absolute bang. They had the lead coming into the Moto Fest a week ago. It was Barry and Stu that really turned up to play. They won the New Zealand TT, and they also took the fight to these two out in front. But then when the championship on the line, the 9-point deficit, they turned up here to play that Boss Engineering Aprilia pairing. And with 2 wins so far, they've got a massive 15-point lead in that championship. And it's definitely going to be something special, or some sort of bad luck, that's going to alter the course of this championship. It's going to be very well deserved, whoever's going to take it out. But the 12 leads the one. There's not a lot in it. As we go raging through the flip-flop, taking off another lap at frantic pace. Let's have a look at some of these lap times on the first flying lap. It's the 12 ahead of the 1 as they tick it off in style. It's a 1:38.7 for both of those pairings. So they're already on really, really good pace, and some pretty challenging conditions out there. Then go to Chris and Richie Lawrence. Third place for them on that Coleman's machine. Fabulous performance for them. And wouldn't that be a cool show to see them lock away 3NZ of the New Zealand Sidecar Grand Prix. Mark Halls and Jeff Davies have got up into fourth place, the first of the F2s home. And we've still got Brian and Dan in behind them, with Tracy and Joe still there. Third place, but starting to get very, very exciting. Not even halfway through the New Zealand Sidecar Grand Prix, and the championships are both live. We talked about that, but it's going to take a bit of bad luck for Adam Unsworth and Bryce Rose. A big 15-point lead in that championship. But it's only 5 points between Mark Halls and Tracy Bryan for that honours there, as the girls have got up into second in the F2 category. Can they start reeling in the pairing of Mark Halls and Jeff Davies? Have a look at the split times here. It was about 7.5 seconds when they crossed the line. So we're going to keep an eye on this one with open eyes. The cat amongst the pigeons is definitely that number 16 machine of Michael Walland and Isaac Taylor. Bert had a bit of troubles here earlier today, but he's put that right, and he'd love to Good showing in here, and potentially a top four in the New Zealand Grand Prix. The Sidecar Racing Association, fabulous to see them coming together. Didn't make the journey to the South Island. It was decided to save it all for the North Island, and man, have we been treated ever since we got back with our sidecars. Fabulous racing, and it's been these two at the front that have been absolutely brilliant. Shout out, good to see Spike Taylor here. He was the leader of this championship after race number one. Unfortunately, a bit of a hiccup for Spike and Kendall at the Motor Fest, and not here racing this weekend. But great to see Spike in the paddock, and fabulous to see them doing well. So have a look at this F1 group out of turn number one. The back end's dancing around. We've got some frantic pace from those two as we see Adam Unsworth and Bryce Rose. Have won two out of two. Can they make the three-peat and lock away that New Zealand Championship? It's all on here. There's a lot to play for Barry Smith and Stu Dorr. Even if they don't win the championship, the New Zealand Grand Prix for Formula One sidecars is up for grabs in five laps time. But Chris and Richie Lawrence settled into a wonderful race pace. They are there in third place. And then this is the battle we're looking out for. Mark Halls and Jeff Davies. They are 3.5 seconds ahead of Tracy Bryan and Joe Mickelson with a massive five laps to go. That is the New Zealand Grand Prix that we're going to look out for, because it's all on. Formula 1 and Formula 2 all come into a crunch here, and it's wonderful to be joined here by a sidecar racing legend, one of my ultimate heroes in the paddock, a former national champion, and Aaron Lovell is here. We'll let him finish his ice cream there, because that's just as important as the New Zealand Sidecar Grand Prix. But the Love Master, Aaron Lovell, what an absolute treat and a joy it is to be joined alongside you in commentary. And how good is this sidecar racing?
This is awesome out here at the moment. Yeah, it's to see those top two out in front there, and of course my old sidecar that was normally right at the front there is running in third, so that's they're doing really well. There's a couple of legends out there as well, so yeah, it's really good.
Right, ticking off another lap there. We've got Adam Unsworth, Bryce Rose. They have got a little bit of a buffer now over Barry Smith and Stu Dorr, 2.2 seconds, and with four laps to go, it's a pretty telling sign and advantage. Adam, in the Grand Prix here, Aaron.
Yeah, it is. It's going to be really good to... it'll be nice to see Barry and Stu get up there a little bit closer and give them a bit of a run for their money, but by the looks of there, maybe their rear tyre's gone off a little bit or something. But yeah, I think Adam has really got that Aprilia up and running really good these days. It's really good to see. I think it's the, correct me if I'm wrong, I think it's the only Aprilia sidecar in the world that's doing this. So yeah, he's done extremely well to get that up and running so well.
Yeah, it's a full credit to that Boss Engineering Aprilia team. The first V4 in a sidecar like that is a phenomenal bit of engineering and putting them on the map worldwide. So credit to them. There have been a lot of hard work and dedication gone into this package, and right now the fruits of their labour coming out to shine as they lead the New Zealand Formula 1 Sidecar Grand Prix. That battle for that Formula 2 glory is now down to just 2 seconds. They were 1.5 seconds quicker that lap along. The girls are coming, and they're out of turn number 7 at the moment, so look out for that one there. That is going to be absolutely brilliant, and what they need to happen is that pairing in third of Brian Stent, Dan Franz, and they need them to come along for the ride, because if they get tied on points, Mark Halls with the awesome 5 race wins this calendar, he will win on the countback. So plenty to look out for, Aaron, and excitement to the max.
Yeah, for sure. Like, it'd be really good to see Tracy, and they've come so far this year to hop in that Formula 2 outfit and do as well as they really are. The two lovely ladies out there on the Carl Cox machine, it's really, really good to see.
All right, we are halfway through the New Zealand Sidecar Grand Prix. There's only 3 laps to go, and Adam Unsworth and Bryce Rose lead Barry Smith and Stu Dorr, but Baz just put the fastest lap of the race in, a purple lap time for them, and the first time into the 137, so a 137.9 for the Carl Cox Motorsport City Honda long bike. This is going to get exciting with only 3 laps to go. We've got Chris and Richie Lawrence still solid there in third place, Mark Halls and Jeff Davies, but it's only narrowly ahead of Tracy Bryan, Joe Mickelson, less than half a second, as it's going to be all on into the first corner. Michael Holland, Isaac Taylor, they'll be 6th in the race, but that's 4th in the F1 class. They're under a bit of pressure from an F2 outfit of Brian Stent and Dan Franz and the St. John's Foursquare in Whanganui supported machine, and the best steak and cheese pies in the Lower North Island, I've been told by Stenty, so look out for that. We've got Peter and Michael Dowman in 8th. We've got Nick Plogue, Marcella Pandula there in 9th, and Peter Bratter and Paul Jenkins. Great to see some of your old mates still doing it out there, Aaron.
Oh, absolutely, yes. It's quite good. I just was saying to a few people before, of down in the Reezers team there, and where the old calf used to be down here, it took me an hour to get from just there to there, which is not even 50 metres, and just catching up with a whole lot of people that obviously still here racing and supporting, you know. It's so good. It's just a big family here. It's you miss it, but you don't miss it. Yeah, like I don't sort of miss the racing so much because of all the stuff you have to get in and do it, but I do still enjoy watching these guys go well.
Oh, there's nothing in it now. We've run across the line and two laps to go. So, well, look at that. Half a second between Adam Unsworth, Bryce Rose and Barry Smith and Stu Dorr. That's your two pairings into turn number one as Baz has a little look up the inside. Not quite close enough. That Boss Engineering Aprilia rig is just so good out of the corners, and they've got it really dialed in under brakes. They've had a wonderful setup this weekend. And where's it going to be, Aaron? Where do you think Baz has got the maybe the legs of the back straight or something special you need?
Oh, I think he's just got to get him in the corners, to be fair, because Aprilia pulls out of the corners really well. So he's got to maybe get him under brakes. And as we come around onto the front straight now, we've actually seen that Tracy's got past Mark Halls. And yeah, look at that.
That unbelievable.
Is fantastic.
Brilliant stuff from the girls. They are the Carl Cox Motorsport F2 pairing, and they have now taken the lead for Formula 2 glory in the New Zealand Sidecar Grand Prix, and that will be locking them on points in the championship. So although the countback will come into play for the trophies, it really essentially will be a first equal in the championship if it finishes like that, Aaron.
Yeah, that's always a bit of a shame when it comes down to the old first equal stuff. But hey, it is what it is, and you know, like that's unfortunately that's racing. But yeah, we certainly need her brother up there to divide the two, but he's a little way back, so I don't think that's going
to
happen.
Oh, great to still have 11 sidecars out on track. Yes. As we've got a lap and a half to go. It is still with the Boss Engineering pairing of Adam Unsworth and Bryce Rose breaking hard into the flip-flop. The white flag is ready and waiting to go here. So they're going to have just one lap to go when we cross the line here as they fire out of turn number 14 and tick off yet another lap here. So we're looking out for that one there. Not sure. I didn't see the white flag come out, so we're going to have to keep racing here, Aaron. We've got the timing screen saying there's only a lap to go, but
it does. It says two. Oh, look down the bottom. Oh, one now. Oh, you're right. Okay, sorry. Yeah.
No, but the old saying, you've got to race to the flag. You've been taught that since you were 5 years old. So the flags are what really count. So look out for it.
That's it.
It just goes to show the commentators don't really know what we're talking about, do we?
Well, yeah, no, we do. We're really onto it up here.
All right, a bit of an update of our top three as they fly through. We've got Adam Unsworth, Bryce Rose, Barry Smith and Stu Dorr, and then Chris and Richie Lawrence still 1, 2 and 3 unchanged over the last handful of laps. But Barry Smith and Stu Dorr, they are piling on the pressure. Where are they going to try and make a move? We're not sure exactly how many laps we've got left, but it's going to be all on here. We've got that F2 battle, Tracy Bryan and Joe Mickelson into the 142, so that is fantastic pace from them. And then look to Mark Halls, Jeff Davies. The other battle that we're seeing on track is a two-class battle. That's Michael Walland, Isaac Taylor there in 6th, and Brian Stent, Dan Franzen there in 7th place. And look out to the downwind pairing of Peter and Michael. They're in 8th place there, but that's going to be 4th in the F2 class. So we love machine level. It's just an absolute pleasure to see you. So tell us a little bit about what you've been up to. How's life?
Yeah, life's actually really good. I did get married about 5 weeks ago to my lovely Lisa. So that was a bit of excitement for a day or so, you know. Otherwise, bit of work and lots of pleasure, so that's good, yeah.
All right, another lap in the white flag this time here. So we've got one lap to go now. The white flag is out for Adam Unsworth and Bryce Rose. Can we see something special from that number one, the defending sidecar champions? They're going to need something out of the hat big time here. The New Zealand F1 Sidecar Grand Prix is on the line. We've got one lap to go. It's pretty much done and dusted for third place. You'd have to imagine, unless something horrible would happen to the Lawrence brothers. But that's fantastic. And talking to Jen before, 30 years ago, 1993, Chris and Richie Lawrence won their first New Zealand sidecar title. Still out there doing it. That has got to be impressive, to say the least, Aaron.
Yeah, I was actually there that day that they won that. So we've certainly been friends for a long time. And it's again, still really good to see them guys. Still out there racing. And, you know, they've done a lot of racing too, you know, but over at the Isle of Man. And of course, a lot here back in New Zealand. So. You know, it's good to see them. I'm very sort of proud for them to be out there racing our old sidecar too. And Richie's boy Peter is actually racing my other old one that we had back in the end of the late 90s. Yeah.
So, this is fabulous. So does it still give you itchy feet? You want to get out there and have another go?
I'm not quite sure, you know. Sometimes you sit there and go, yeah, maybe, but then you just remember all the work that goes on behind the scenes. This is all the good stuff that we see when they're out in the track, and that's it. You go, oh, that's all they do, but yeah.
All right, here it is. This is exciting stuff. The New Zealand Formula One Sidecar Grand Prix is about to get decided. It's Adam Unsworth and Bryce Rose out of the final corner. They've got it done, and this is brilliant. So the Aprilia team goes 3 from 3 in the weekend and win the New Zealand Sidecar Grand Prix. Barry Smith and Stu Dorr, they have had an up-and-down season, but they'll come home with that one there, second in the race, and is second to NZ. And look out for Chris and Richie Lawrence with that. They'll be third in the Grand Prix, third in the championship, and phenomenal stuff. But looking out, Aaron, we've had some great racing, and good to see sidecars as good as ever.
Yeah, it is. It really is. It's very good fields, and it's actually it's good that they've now divided the F1 and the F2s up. It's been a long time coming, and you know, like for them to have the two championships out there and the both classes to be very well presented, and also, you know, lots of sidecars in the both classes. So yeah, it is. It's fantastic. The whole day's been great. It's been good to come down here and watch again. But yeah, it's fantastic. There goes Tracy and Joe there across the line there.
They'll be absolutely pumped. That's a Formula 2 New Zealand Sidecar Grand Prix. They'll be even on points with Mark Halls and Jeff Davies, but unfortunately for them, the countback is not going to be kind on them. They are going to come home equal with points, but Mark Halls with his 5 wins in this championship, he's going to take the New Zealand Formula 2 Sidecar Championship. That's going to be pretty exciting for him and the whole CTR Chris Throw Racing team. Well done to them. And then we look to Brian Stent and Dan Franz, and they're going to come home in third in our Formula 2 New Zealand Sidecar Grand Prix ahead of Peter Damon and Michael Dowman, that Dowman Racing team. Awesome stuff. They've had father and both son and daughter on the side of the machine. All part of our awesome sidecar family. Shout out to Peter Bradder and Paul Jenkins. They're home in ninth place. And Nick Bloke, Marcelo Pandiela, they're rounding out our top 10 in the awesome New Zealand Sidecar Grand Prix. Just a note on the awards as well. We're going to have prize giving 30 minutes after the conclusion of racing. Everyone more than welcome to join you. Join us. It is going to be fantastic. What a 6-round season we've had. And it's been fantastic. So there you go, Aaron. The New Zealand Sidecar Grand Prix. And all pretty spectacular in the end, really.
Yeah, it was very, very good. Yeah, absolutely. And thank you very much for having me up here.
Oh, thank you for joining us. Oh, it's an absolute pleasure, and we don't bump into you enough, so do continue to come and see us. It's fabulous.
It probably scares you that you don't bump into me, that's why.
It's always fantastic to be joined with former legend and New Zealand sidecar champion Aaron Lovell. It's phenomenal to have you here, and we'll cross down to Neil, who will have some joy and elation. He's got 12 people to interview. There's three pairings in both different classes, so 12 interviews to do. We're going to go down to him now, and he's going to wrap up our New Zealand Sidecar Grand Prix and do our championship digestion. It's going to be a big podium to get through, so we'll cross down to Neil.
Hey, there's a fair bit of activity going on down here, and we'll get it on it because Casey wants to get on board here with the machine. He's going to hop right on board there. As we look right over here in the distance, we've got the camera over there, and Chris over here. 30 years this year. Thank you for the story. 30 years since you first won a sidecar title. That's pretty impressive, Christopher.
Oh, well, that makes me sound old, doesn't it?
No, you're 21.
Yeah, that's right. So yeah. Another 30 years to win another one, maybe.
Yeah.
So, yeah. It's been good to still be racing all this time, and a couple more years left in me, maybe.
Hey, do you think that, like, what's the improvement? Is the sidecar, is it 30 years better today? Is that part of the reason you can race as well, because they have better technology than they used to be?
Oh, yeah, I find those little Formula 2 bikes hard to ride. You know, I haven't got the strength to ride them anymore, but these are a little bit easier to ride and a bit more power, like the speed. So.
The speed, well done. We're going to see you back next year?
Yeah, I guess so.
Well done. Let's hear it. Team Lawrence, come on. Well done. Thank you, Chris and Richie. Pretty impressive, to say the least. And we're over here with Casey. Was that a good drive?
Good.
Good, yeah, that's better. All right. How was Granddad? Is he fast?
Well, Adam's engine is quite fast.
Adam's engine's quite fast. Oh, I like that. Yeah. What sort of engine's he got, do you know? No, you don't know. What sort of engine's Granddad got?
Aprilia.
Oh, mate, they're trying to brainwash the poor kid. You know what sort of engine this has got. What sort has it got?
Kawasaki.
Oh, there you go, hey? Hearing it from the kids as well. Pretty cool. Stu, you had some fun?
Yeah, mate, it's been a good season. I'd like just to thank everyone's put the event on, all the oranges. We need them, definitely. Yeah, so, yeah, it's been a good season for what we've had in the past. So, yeah, we'll take that.
We'll take that. Well done. Around the banner here and looking at the camera for us, Baz, and not the perfect season, but hey, you've still raced and you've finished. Got to be a positive, isn't it?
Of course it is. Yeah. We were surprised the old motor kept going all season, to be honest.
Okay.
We lost a good engine at Manfield, and we've been on the backup motor for the rest of the season, so it's done us proud, really. Especially against this thing, it's so fucking fast.
Hey, that's honesty, if ever we've heard it, but we'll have that the old good engine that'll be back next year.
Oh, we got some plans for next year. We'll be out to beat these guys, no doubt.
Yeah. Whoa, there's fighting talk. Well done, fighting talk. Thank you. Back over here with Bryce and Adam. First of all, Bryce, coming over here, mate, because the camera's just around here as we've been doing our bed, but they're having some fun.
Oh, we had a ball out there in the last one, eh? You know, I absolutely loved it. Adam rode a smart race, and right from start to finish, it was massive team effort to get to where we are today, eh? So, but I'd just like to congratulate both Barry and Stu. I've always said throughout my whole racing career, to be the best, you've got to beat the best.
Yeah.
And that's where I hold Barry and Stu. They had a flawless season last year, and hands down. And for our team to work for that 20 months of preparation to come back and to do what we've done, we're over the moon, mate.
Well done. Beautiful words. Thank you from the heart. That is Adam. Mate, how good to have that guy on your team. Isn't it cool?
Hasn't he done well?
Yeah, he's done. Yeah, exactly. Look, is well said. 20 months of planning. You know, it doesn't happen overnight.
Oh, no, that's right. You know, what you see today, that's just... if you saw what had gone on, you know, in the background with the team over the last 20 months, you'd fully understand. But, you know, what a privilege to... become the New Zealand champions, and even more with an Aprilia. You know, it's never been done before, and I tell you what, Monday morning I cannot wait to send the email off to the racing Aprilia Racing Factory in Noale and give them the good results.
Well done. Hey folks, here for our sidecar champions to Bryce and Adam, you are awesome ambassadors, and well done to Aprilia. Fantastic, and this beautiful chair as well. Hey, we're quickly going to, oh no, we've got it the other way. No, wait, what have we mixed up here? Is this a series, is it? It doesn't matter who we are. I'm going to go to the ladies first because I'll be looking for a start. All right, so let's just get our facts right here. You beat the boys, is that right?
We beat the boys, yes.
Thank you, that's all we need to hear. Hey, but the three of you are all so close. We took the F1 guys out of it, and it'd still be an exciting race.
Yeah, it's actually been really epic racing out there this series. We've been having a lot of fun, a lot of battles, and it's good to see the boys, Dan and Brian, back here this weekend to have a bit of a tussle with us as well.
Does it feel neat to beat your partner as well? Like, you know, come on, is that really cool? Come on, be honest.
No, you know what feels really neat is just being out on track and getting to have a good battle with him.
Yeah.
There's something really special in that, and it's so fun for us to be able to come off the track and have a yarn together and really get excited about it.
Well, all I can say is it's got to be the best pillow talk in the world, doesn't it?
Yeah, I mean, that's not bad.
Oh, not bad. It's right up there. Thank you. All right, Trey, something special, eh? How cool?
Pretty awesome to win the GP, actually. Because we were tied for points, and unfortunately, it goes on a count back, and Mark's got me. So I'm glad we did this, because someone said there was a bottle of wine if you won.
Oh, really? Oh, okay.
We went real fast.
Yeah, we went real fast. Didn't they do well? Come on, the fastest ladies in the world in sidecars. Well done. Great to see. Where are we? Over here. Here we are. Nothing four square about that, mate.
No. we did a little better in the Tri-Series, or Suzuki's International Series, I should say. But it's still been good to come out here and still have a crack, you know. We didn't quite have the right gearing today, unfortunately, but still, we're getting out there, having some fun. So.
Right, hey, we talk about these North Island circuits, and aren't they so different? Like, you go back, you guys at Manfield, mate, that just rocks, isn't it? That's cool stuff for F2 sidecars.
Absolutely. Every circuit that we've got up here really tests a different aspect of your skill. You've got the tight technical sort of left rights here, and then you've got the higher speed sweeping corners at Manfield, and then Whanganui, which is a completely different kettle of fish altogether. Yeah. It's wonderful. Great racing.
Well done. Thank you, Brian Stenty. Hey, mate, for a long time, mate, the classic sidecar with you and Super Sis there was great, but now your own rigging out there and doing it. Hey, good company and good racing.
Yeah, great racing. Neil had a good time this year. Loved Whanganui as normal.
Yes, yeah.
But yeah, she's for sale.
Okay.
So yeah, going back to the classic.
All right.
Yeah, new one coming. So yeah, we'll have a bit of fun on that. Yeah.
Good stuff. Well done indeed. And finally here, let's quick. And is this racing going on? Jeff, the girls beat you. What went wrong? Ooh, it was rough, Neil.
That was a rough call. look, the girls did bloody well. We knew we just had to be with them and close to them. So once they got past, we just... Yeah, just followed them home, but they did really well.
Good fun?
Yeah, definitely good fun. Hard work.
You can hold on?
Yeah, just about.
Sir, well done, matey. A lot of good memories here. This is cool stuff. You've got a lot of your life unfolded in these last few weeks, haven't you?
Yeah, it's unbelievable to win a New Zealand Championship and all that sort of stuff. I mean, that last race with Tracy, that's the most enjoyable spanking I've ever had in my life. I knew all I had to do was finish second, you know. I've got to say a massive thanks to Chris for letting us ride the sidecar, and to all our sponsors, Marketing Works, Motor Mail, Inox New Zealand, R&R Power Sports, Alltech Diesel and Turbo. Without them, we couldn't do what we do. We've had an up and down year, but to come out of the season with the Auckland Championships, the TT title, second place in the GP and the New Zealand Championship, we're going to get seriously drunk tonight.
Woohoo! There you go. You heard it from the boys. Well done. Congrats, sidecars. And over to you. Sorry, mate.
If anybody wants to buy a New Zealand Championship winning F2 sidecar, it's up for sale.
There you go. So well done. Thank you, Brad.
Oh, brilliant stuff. Well done to our sidecar champions. Well deserved down there. Let's go straight into it. We're halfway through this amazing Supersport 150 final race of the program. They have had six this weekend. This is number six. And the top four has just been breathtaking. They're at it again as Hunter, Charlotte, Tate and Fordyce, Nixon, Frost and Tyler King. It's Nixon up the inside, so he now inherits the lead for the first time in this race. It's Hayden Fordyce right there in second. Hunter, Charlotte, he is in third with Tyler King in fourth. Then you look back and it's a great three-way fight in behind them as well, as we've got Reeve Lee, Connor Cox and Lucas Guthrie all going at it for 5th, 6th and 7th place. And then look out for Kieran Meir. A wonderful job from Kieran double classing this weekend with this 6th race weekend for the Supersport 150s plus his 300 duties. He will be feeling that, but a wonderful young man on the TSS Motorcycles, Dr. Steve supported Moto Academy New Zealand race team, and fabulous to have him here. So 8th place for him. Eva Wintle is in 9th at the moment. That is the second of the Jixers home on the Penrite Oils racing machine. Well done to Eva, that's brilliant. And in behind her, Joe Stroud ahead of Nathan Finlay and Cadle with Blaine Pyrama there is 13th. Emma Dowman, more of our girl power out here in the lineup. She is there in quality 14th, and Alexander there. That'll be 15th place at the moment with still a big two laps to go. Don't go anywhere after this one. A massive feature race for our Hyosung and Ninja 400. So that's going to be a 10-lap feature race scheduled to get underway at the conclusion of this one here. And then half an hour after that there, we've got our amazing prize giving. Please do stick around if you're on the track, as we've got plenty to keep a lookout for. as we're trying to keep an eye on our race leaders. It is going to be something special to keep an eye on. As the white flag already ready and go. These short, we had some 4-lap races on the Saturday, 3 of those. We've had 5-lap races here today and a 6-race program. It's been absolutely fantastic. The future of the sport is looking brilliant. And they're still that four-way train into turn number 12 they go. The awesome iconic flip-flop here at Taupo International Motorsport Park. Nixon Frost with Tyler King breaking hard. He's going to have to try and pull that thing up on the apex. It's going to play into the hands of Nixon. So that's your top four, as you see it. Nixon Frost, Tyler King, Hayden Fordyce, and Hunter Charlotte as the white flag comes out. 1 lap to go. And this amazing Supersport 156th race on the program. And man, have they packed some action into these six races or what? As Tyler King tries to have a little dive up the inside for the lead, goes in a little bit deep. Nixon Frost makes the mistake, runs a little bit wide out of turn one, and now Hayden Fordyce, who was third about 60 metres ago, he's now the race leader. And Hunter Charlotte there trying to hang on desperately to this podium fight. One of those four is going to miss out on a podium. We've had a few four-way tussles with them. It's not really fair because it's been breathtaking racing, but we've still got half a lap to decide who is going to come home. Reeve Lee, shout out to Reeve on that Promoto machine, is fifth place. Connor Cox in sixth, and then Kieran Meir and Lucas Guthrie seventh and eighth. And this brilliant Supersport 150, man, it's been spectacular.
My apologies to the gentleman that said how many more races to go, and I showed him one. No, sorry, there was two. My apologies. Completely lost track of this one. Yes, because they've had a double points round because, it's not double points. There's been double the amount of racing for them as they missed out on the affairs, I should say, at MotoFest. And there was a reason for that. People are saying it was wrong. No, because we wouldn't have had Joey. We wouldn't have had the Masterpiece. We wouldn't have had MotoFest. So let's mix it all up. It's not, to me, a right or a wrong. It's a matter of trying to balance and get everything in there. So I think it's a great fix. So a real fan of what we've done over the series this year. Take a bow, Andy and your team. You are absolutely awesome. Alistair and co, thanks as well. A shout out to our hero from Dunedin, KG. You're absolutely brilliant. So really do appreciate so many people and your input behind the scenes making it happen. You know, as Brad pointed out before, you know, somebody like Dennis Charlotte, he's a father, he's a husband, he's a bike shop owner, he's a racer, he's a sponsor, he's a champion, and he's a board member, right? You don't get much better than that. Sir Dennis Charlotte, you are amazing. So,
all right, let's get excited about it. The final call of the chequered flag waves. Who's it going to be? It's going to be Hayden Fordyce. He's going to hang on and win it ahead of Tyler King. And then look out, Nixon Frost is going to come home in third place. What a last lap.
Hunter misses out.
And
there's podium winner. The champion.
Only 0.3 seconds cover the whole top four. That's unbelievable. So fantastic racing from those guys. And credit to Hayden Fordyce, gets the job done. And he'll be loving that. So he thoroughly deserves that. He is going to fly the flag for New Zealand well and truly in the OJC, yeah. The Oceania Junior Cup, where we've got Hayden, Nixon and Hunter all out there doing battle, flying the Kiwi flag in the Australian Superbike Championships. Well done and fantastic. Also, shout out to Luca Durning and Morgan McLaren-Wood. They will be in the Supersport 600 in 2 weeks' time in the Sydney round of the Australian Superbike Championship. So look out for that. You can catch that on ASBK TV and follow all the Kiwis flying the flag over there as we wrap up this one here. Reeve Lee is going to come home in fifth. Connor Cox there in sixth. Kieran Meir is in seventh, the first of the Jixers. So that's a shout out. And well done to Kieran. He's done every race of this championship. And to bring his Jixer home for 4NZ is a full credit to that man. And wonderful. We'll love to catch up with him and the rest of you at the prize giving. We are going to be there 30 minutes after the conclusion of the final race, so can't wait to see you there as Hayden Fordyce ahead of Tyler King and Nixon Frost. That'll be your podium. We're going to go down to Neil very shortly, and then in behind we had Hunter Charlotte, Reeve Lee, Connor Cox, Kieran Meir, and then Eva Wintle's going to come home and be the second of the Jixers. That's 8th place. Cadel's going to come home there and hold on to 9th, Nathan Finlay in 10th. Joe Stroud there in 11th ahead of Emma Dowman on the Dowman Racing number 31 machine. Blaine Pyrama in 13th and Alexander Leconte there all the way down to 14th place. So pretty good stuff as it's unfolding as we see it here with Hayden, Tyler and Nixon. We'll go down to Neil, who'll have our Supersport 150 podium, their sixth and final race of the weekend. And there's just one more to go. Our Hyosung and Ninja Cups are coming up next.
Hey, the irony of this is that Hunter has won the championship but did not make the podium in the last race. How many last lap dramas we had today? Superbikes in the first win for Al, and Mitch doesn't quite finish with the perfect record. Jesse Stroud getting his first win, saved it in the last race. Hamish Simpson getting his best performance, saved it for the last race. Nixon has made the podium, saved it for the last race. So many cool stories and so much drama. Nixon, you had a good time this weekend?
Yeah, it was amazing. It kind of sucked how my bike kept on cutting out, but for this race we managed to fix the problem for the moment. So.
Oh, that's awesome. Good news. All right, so OJC coming up as well for you. Nixon, you're looking forward to another trip to Oz?
Yeah, can't wait for it. We're going up to Eastern Creek, and I'm a lot better than I am last year. Like, last year I was at the back. This year I'm competing with the front group, I hope. So yeah. Hopefully this year can be a lot better.
All right, mate. Hey, you know, you've been in that position. You did well in karting. You've had a go now at doing motorcycle. You're really enjoying your road racing?
Yeah, it's really amazing. Kind of sucks that I crashed out of the Nationals, but still a great time.
Well done, great result. Let's hear it. Come on, folks, for Nixon Frost. Good performance and a beautiful speech to go with it as well. So cool stuff, cool stuff. Here's Hayden. Man, the excitement as he went across the finish line. Yeah, that's what it's about. Congratulations.
Thanks. I was so excited to get that first place again.
Yeah. So. Mate, you had to work for that. What a cool class. You know, do you realise 0.3 of a second separating all four of you? Pretty close.
Yeah, that was insane. Just that close, such close battles with everyone else is so much fun.
Good on you, Hayden. Well done. I'm going to talk to Hunter because Hunter's here and he got the fourth place. But first of all, I'm going to talk to you as if you're Tyler because Tyler's about to go out on air. Did Tyler do well?
Yeah, he did.
Like, he did, yeah. How did he go?
Pretty good, yeah.
Yeah, pretty good. All right. Has he got a fast bike?
Not really.
Oh, not really. Okay, so now from a Hunter point of view, why only in fourth place, Hunter? Did they have it on you or did you make a mistake? What happened?
I was just trying to slipstream. I went on the outside. Hayden kind of moved over and we nearly touched. So I was on the outside trying to brake as hard as I could because I was going to go off.
Wow, listen to the technical layout of this man. He's got knowledge. He knows all about it. It's a little mistake, but it's sort of like it's a raffle ticket, isn't it? Because if you didn't give it a go, you may not have gained anything. Nothing ventured, nothing gained, as they say.
Nah.
Yeah, exactly. Cool, mate. Have you had a great weekend?
Yeah, it's been awesome, yeah.
You like doing the double header? Do you like coming to do six races and not just three?
Yep, much better.
Yeah, much better. Yeah, right. Got a few people to thank, Hunter?
Yep, I got Kevin, again, my dad, mum, all the other guys for great racing and all that.
Well done, great words. There we are, that's our 150. We'll have Tyler, we'll have Hunter, we've got Hayden, and we've got Nixon there. Great to see you. All right, folks, our final race on the warm-up for the Hyosungs today, and we'll have a great podium for them at the end of it as well.